I'll show you the syndromes for this particular example. So syndromes, as number of the error correcting capability of 15,7 is 2, total syndromes will be 2 into TC, that is 4. So S1, S2, S3, S4 will be there. And as you know, we calculate the syndromes by replacing AX by alpha I. So for S1, it will be replaced by, X will be replaced by alpha. So S1 is alpha 12. I hope you have got the correct answer. Then S2 is alpha 9. We just replace X by alpha square in the received code word. So S2 is alpha 9. Now obviously S2 will be S1 square. So S1 square is alpha 12 raised to 2. So that is alpha 24. So alpha 24 in G of 2 raised to 4 is alpha 9. Okay, so S2 is alpha 9. Then S3 is alpha raised to 10. Just by replacing AX by alpha cube. So S3 is alpha 10. Then S4 is alpha cube. So S4 will be what simply? It will be S2 square. So alpha 9 square means what? Alpha 18. So obviously it will be alpha 3. So these are the syndromes: alpha 12, alpha 9, alpha 10, and then alpha cube. So have you got the answer? Have you solved the question? Have you solved the numerical? Anyone? No? Okay, so you can write the answers, the syndromes for the given example. If you solve the question, if you solve the numerical, you can cross verify your answers with the given solution. So write down this S1, S2, S3, S4. So as you know, this relation that S2 is S1 square and S4 is S2 square is valid only for BCH code. It is not valid for the RS code. You can verify with the this formula. You have written this S1 to S4. So then next is what? Finding out the number of errors present in the given RX. So as P is equal to, we are going to assume that the maximum number of errors are present. That means the maximum number of errors that can this BCH code can correct. We are going to assume that number of errors are present. So TC is equal to 2. So we are going to assume that there are 2 errors in the given received code word. So as TC is equal to 2 or P is equal to 2, your M will be of order 2 by 2. So it will be S1, S2, and then second row will be S2, S3. So as you know, if a determinant of M doesn't come as singular, then it will be assumed that it will be concluded that the number of errors present equal to what? That we assume that P is equal to 2. So number of errors are 2 as determinant of M is alpha 4. So then next is what? Finding out the error location. So error locator polynomial will be used to calculate the error error locations. So as the degree is P is equal to 2, your degree of this error locator polynomial will be 2. So this will be the matrix format for finding out the mu2 and mu1, the locations. So S1, S2, S2, S3 into mu2, mu1 is equal to S3. S4. So by taking M to the right hand side, it will be M inverse. So to first you calculate M inverse. M inverse is nothing but what? Cofactor of M divided by determinant of M. In this case, cofactor is calculated by just swapping the position of this element with this element. So, and this S2 and S2 will be as it is. So determinant of M is alpha 4, and then we will divide it each and every element of this cofactor of M by alpha 4. So what is the M inverse? It is alpha 6, alpha 5, alpha 5, alpha 8. You can just write down this M inverse. This is alpha 6, alpha 5, alpha 5, and alpha 8. So then next is, so this is your M inverse and into S3 and S4. So I think I have not replaced the actual values. So actual values are, should be, your S3 is alpha 10 and S4 is alpha cube. They should be like that. This is, I think, wrong. I have not replaced the original values. So it is not correct. So I'll give the actual solution after the session or in next session. But this is your correct answer. EX is equal to X4 and alpha, sorry, plus X6. So location error location is 4 and 6. Okay. So the next is so let's consider this example for today's session, because we have not solved the example having triple error correcting capability. So just write down this example 15,5. Just write down this example and try to solve this example. Everyone, please write down this example. It is having triple error correcting capability. So the cofactor of M will be different. And then also the calculation of roots of that error locator polynomial will be different than the double error correcting polynomial. So it is important to solve this example with the triple error correcting capability. So write down this. Now remember, they have not given the transmitted code word or the generator polynomial. So you cannot directly tell how many errors are present and at which location errors are present. So we need to solve this example thoroughly from step number 1 to step number 4. So just write down this. I hope you are writing this example. Your first step is calculation of the syndromes. So as the triple error correcting capability is given, TC will be 3 and the number of syndromes will be 2 into TC. So if you are done with the question, please let me know. Okay, so first is what? Step number 1 is find the syndrome. So number of syndromes is equal to what? 2 into TC, that is 2 into 3, 6. So how many syndromes will be there? S1 to S6 syndromes will be there. So you need to calculate S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. So do one thing, calculate S1 and using that shortcut, short trick, calculate S2 and S4. Okay, so your see what is your R? It is 01001010100011. So the vector is given and the polynomial form is, you are starting with, now this is 15 length 15 code vector. So your starting 0 is nothing but the coefficient of the highest order of the x. So the 0 is the coefficient of x raised to 14. That's why the term is not included. Now next is 1. So 1 is the coefficient of x raised to 13. That's why this x 13 is present in the R of x. Similarly, so 13, 12 and 11 are not included because the coefficient are 0. Then 10, the coefficient is 1. That's why 10 is included. Then 9, the coefficient is 0. That's why 0 x raised to 9 is not included. Similarly, you can calculate the remaining things. So your R of x is x13, x10, x8, x4 plus x plus 1. Just write down this R of x because you need to calculate syndromes using this R of x. Have you written the R of x? So what will be your first syndrome? S1 will be equal to what? R of alpha 1. As I is equal to 1, you are going to replace x in R of x by alpha. So simple. So alpha 13, alpha 10, alpha 8, alpha 4 plus alpha plus 1. So S1 is alpha 12. Just try to find out the answer. Okay, correct. So S1 is alpha 12. Okay, correct. So Shubhangi has got the answer. So S1 is alpha 12. So S2 will be what? S2 will be what? It will be S1 square. So 12 square means what? 12 raised to 2. So S12 into S12. Alpha 12 into alpha 12 is alpha 24. So S2 will be alpha 9. Okay. So simple is S2 will be what? Alpha 9. You can calculate the S2 by replacing alpha square in R of x later. But just write S2 is equal to what? S1 square. So S1 square is alpha raised to 12 square. So alpha 12 into alpha 12 is nothing but what? Alpha 24. Calculate S3. So S1 is alpha 12, S2 is alpha 9. Calculate S3. Tell me what is the value of S3. What is S3? Have you calculated the S3? So S3 is what? Alpha 10. Correct. Alpha 10 is correct answer. So S3 is nothing but what? You'll replace x by alpha cube. So alpha 39, then alpha 30, alpha 24, then alpha 12. And then alpha q plus 1. So alpha 39 means what? Alpha 9, because divided by 15, whatever is the remainder, that will be your answer. So alpha 9, alpha 30 is 1, alpha 24 is 9. So this part will get cancelled with alpha 9 plus 1, then alpha 12 and alpha 3. That means what? Alpha square plus alpha plus 1, which is alpha 10. So alpha 10 is correct answer. Then what will be S4? Tell me, what will be S4? S4 is nothing but what? S2 square. So what is S2? It is alpha 9. So alpha 9 square. So what will be S4? Tell me. S4 will be S2 square. So alpha 9 square. It will be what? Alpha 18. That means alpha 3. So S4 is alpha cube. Okay, so then you need to calculate alpha 5. Huh? You have to calculate alpha 5. Calculate S5 by replacing alpha 5 in place of x in R of x. So instead of x in R of x, you have to replace x by alpha raised to 5. So tell me, what is the value of S5? What is S5? So it will be simply what? Alpha 65 plus alpha, okay, alpha 5 is. Shubhangi has got the answer, that is alpha 5. That is correct answer. So it will be alpha 65 plus alpha 50 plus alpha 40 plus alpha 20 plus alpha 5 plus 1. It will be simply alpha 5, alpha 5 plus alpha 10, alpha 5 plus alpha 5. So alpha 5, alpha 5. There are 4 alpha 5. They all will get cancelled with each other. So alpha 10 plus 1, which is equal to what? Alpha 5. Have you got the answer? That is alpha 5. S5 is equal to alpha 5. Okay. Now alpha 6. Write on this alpha, S5 is equal to alpha 5. Alpha 6 will be S3 square. Remember the trick part for calculation of the syndrome. S2 is S1 square and S4 is S2 square. S6 is S3 square. So what is S3? It is alpha 10. So S6 is alpha 10 square. So what is alpha 10 square? It is alpha 20, so S6 will be again alpha 5. Remember this thing. See, these are your answers. Those who have not got the answer, you can write down these syndromes S1 to S6. See this short method to calculate the syndrome. S2 will be S1 square, S4 will be S2 square, and S6 will be S3 square. Okay, so once you are done, please let me know if you have written all the values of S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. Remember, you need to calculate S1, S3 and S5 at least. Then and then you can calculate S2, S4 and S6 from this. Shortcut. Okay. Done. So now remember, the first step is done. You have calculated all the 6 syndromes. Now you need to calculate the number of errors present in the given received code word. So can we proceed? So see. The TC is given as 3, so we are going to assume that received code word contains 3 number of errors. So we are going to assume that P is equal to TC, which is equal to 3. So here, number of errors present in, we are assuming that number of errors present in R of X are 3. That's why P is equal to 3. Now, I have told you, if P is equal to 3, your M will be of order 3/3. Okay, so you can write down this. Assume that P is equal to, that is number of errors present is equal to P, which is equal to TC, which is equal to what? 3. Okay. So your M will be of order 3. That is 3/3. I hope you are writing this down. Don't write this M and these conditions. You know that these conditions. So what will be your M? your M will be S1, S2, S3. Your first row and first column will be same. Then S2, S3, S4. Second row and second column will be same. And then last row or last column will be same. That is S3, S4, S5. Because you are starting with S1, S2 up to what? SP. Now, P is equal to 3. That is S3. Similarly, for first row, it is started from S1, S2 up to what? SP. That is equal to what? S3. So, similarly, for last row or last column, it will be SP plus 1. And then last will be what? S2P minus 1. 2P minus 1 means what? 2 into 3, that is 6. 6 minus 1 is what? 5. So, S5. Okay. So, just calculate the determinant of M, because we need to find what is the determinant of M. Okay. Calculate the determinant of M. Now tell me, what is the value? So I have calculated the value of determinant of M. It will be simply what? Just regular mathematics. That is alpha 12 into what? This matrix. So alpha 10 into alpha 5 is alpha 15 plus alpha 10. What is your answer? Please tell me. I think this is wrong, because it should be alpha 3 into alpha 3. So alpha 6 should be there. This is wrong. Alpha 3 into alpha 3 should be alpha cube, and then alpha 9 means what? Alpha 14, that is alpha 9 into alpha 5. Then alpha 10 into alpha 3 will be alpha. This is wrong actually. What is your answer for this? Please let me know. Just calculate the values. Please let me know what is your answer. I will show the actual notes. Alpha 14. Has anyone got the answer? Alpha 14. Please let me check. Okay, answer is alpha 4 actually. So alpha 12 into alpha 15 minus alpha 6, then alpha 9, alpha 14 minus alpha 13, and then alpha 10. If you can see, alpha 10 is alpha 10 into alpha 12 minus alpha 20. So alpha 4 is answer actually. The alpha answer is correct, alpha 4. Has anyone got the answer that determinant of m is equal to alpha 4? Are you solving the determinant of m? Alpha 4 is the correct answer. Anyone else has got the answer? Please let me know. Because 30 minutes have already passed for this session. Has anyone got the answer that is alpha 4? Determinant of m is equal to alpha 4. Kalyani, please calculate the determinant of m again. It is alpha 4, not alpha 14. I think I have written the answer directly. Actually, I didn't write the actual matrix. So, determinant of m is equal to alpha 4. So, remember your number of errors are equal to 3. Has anyone got the answer? Please let me know. Because we are solving the numerical based on triple error correcting code. Now it will require some more time, at least 30 minutes. So please try to solve this as soon as possible. Determinant of m is equal to alpha 4. Has anyone got the answer? No? Okay, just write down this. It is alpha 4. Okay, this is correct. So determinant of m is equal to alpha 4. So write down this: as m is non-singular, number of errors, whatever we assume that p is equal to 3, it is correct. That means there are 3 errors present in the code word. Okay, now what is next part? You need to find out the locations of error. So alpha 4 is correct answer. Kalyani has got the answer. So we'll move forward. So remember, we need to find the error locations for the all 3 errors. So what is the formula for finding out the error locations? It is solved using what? The error locator polynomial, which is mu z. Now what is mu z? You know that mu p into z raised to p plus mu p minus 1 z raised to p minus 1 up to what? 1. So this is your formula for finding out the coefficient of mu z, that is mu p minus 1 up to what? Mu 1. So I hope you have written these formulas in last session. So what is your actual formula for triple error code? Triple error correcting code, it will be from S1 to what? S2, S3, S4, S5. Into what? Mu 3, mu 2, mu 1, and right hand side will be from starting with what? Sp plus 1. So sp plus 1 is what? 3 plus 1, that is 4, and up to 2p. So s3, s5, s2p. That will be s6. So just write down this. So formula for calculating the coefficients of error locator polynomial will be like this. Right on the left hand side, right on the right hand side. If you are done with the formula, please tell me, let me know. Okay. Okay, done. So So it will be your right hand side, left hand side. Left hand side will be what? M into mu 2 mu 3 mu 3 mu 2 mu 1. So let us take M to the right hand side. So it will be M inverse. So finding out the M inverse of 3 by 3 matrix is like this. So let's consider M is equal to A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. So if I were to find the first element of the cofactor M, so leave this column, leave this row, whatever is the remaining part will be this for calculating the first element of the cofactor M. If you are calculating the first element means suppose this, the first row and first column element. So leave the first row, leave the first column, remaining part is EFHI. So you have to take the determinant of EFHI for calculating the first element of the cofactor M. So this is the first row, first column element. That's why you need to leave the first column and first row of matrix M as it is and take the remaining part. So EFHI is the remaining part. Take the determinant of EFHI. Then similarly, if you are calculating the first row, second column element, so you need to leave the first row and the second column. So what is the remaining part? D, F, G, I. So second column, first row element is DF, GI. So determinant of DF, GI. So write down this formula. This is your formula for calculating the cofactor of M. Now see, there is only 5 minutes in this session. I want you to write this formula. Then calculate the cofactor of M using that syndrome values. And after we join the second session, we resume the second session. I need to tell me what is the cofactor of M and what is M inverse. So write down this formula, cofactor formula, very carefully. Remember, if you are calculating this, suppose second row, second column element, then what is your, you need to leave this second row and second column as it is. So your cofactor will be calculated by taking the determinant of A, C, G, I. So A, C, G, I means what? The determinant of only first row and last row. You need to leave second row and second column element as it is. Remaining element you need to take for determinant. Okay, I hope this is clear. Please write down this formula. We will meet again after 15 minutes. We'll take the 15 minute break. So we'll meet at 11:20. Okay, at 11:20. It is 11:07. So let's take 30 minutes break. At 11:20, please tell me what is the cofactor of M and what is the M inverse. Determinant of M is alpha 4. I will make the corrections in my PPT. Okay, sure. I will stop the meeting here, end the meeting here, and we'll meet at 11:20.